Right now, I am going to go, in this video, over emergency procedures. Now, there's a BF-109 right on my ass, and I'm going to go ahead and say I'm out of bullets or something like that, and I need to get rid of him. So what you can do is you can force a stall on your own plane. Now, this is very likely going to get you killed unless you put a spin into it, like this. So he won't hit me, and he's going to fly over me. Now, once you're in a stall like this, it can be difficult to recover. Throttle all the way down, push your stick forward, and then slowly climb out of the roll. I don't recommend doing that unless you absolutely cannot get someone off your tail, because stalling is essentially making yourself a sitting duck. So I'm going to try to ignore this BF-109 over here. And what's he doing? You gonna crash? Oh, I guess he's doing his own. Oh, wow. Way to go, buddy. Alrighty. So now that we've got no more people flying around, I'm gonna show you a little bit about stall recovery and emergency landings, those sorts of things. How to land without landing gear, how to land without your engine, and all the wonderful awesomeness that that entails. Another thing is engine overheating. You'll notice my engine's overheating right now. So I'm going to hit my radiator button and put it to open. That won't immediately reduce the cooling, but once I throttle down and let the radiator work for a little while keeping my speed up, it'll start cooling down my engine. You don't want to go too slow, otherwise your engine will stay hot. There we go, my engine's back to normal now. Now the radiator is a physical manifold on the plane. You can see it right there. Sometimes it'll be on the top part of your engine up here on most planes, but it's there, those little flaps right there. And I'm going to close my radiator because having the radiator open reduces your airspeed. So you don't want to have your radiator open when you're in combat unless your engine's about to explode. So another point would be stalling. I'm going to go ahead and gain some altitude, and I am going to come back and show you guys how to, well, what will get you into a stall, and multiple types of stalls, how to get out of the stalls, and then how to avoid them. Alright, so the first thing we need to cover is, what is a stall? Now, a lot of people think that stalling is when you pull up, lose airspeed, and then flop over like a fish. But that is not always the case. You don't have to be flying up to stall. In a lot of planes with good flap space and interesting aerodynamics, particularly the P-51 Mustang, you can stall while flying straight ahead at full speed. So I'm going to show you how to do that. I'm going about 420 kilometers per hour. Now if I jerk back on the stick right now, I'm going to start flopping over, and there we go. We just got into a stall while moving forward. Those ones are pretty easy to recover from because you'll usually flop out of them going at an angle, and you can just point your plane in that angle and carry on out of it. So those ones you don't really need to worry about too much, but it's important to know that you can stall your plane while flying level. Also, while turning, that's another great way to stall your plane. If you're trying to turn and you're turning too hard, your plane will start to shake like this. You can notice that my plane is shaking and it's starting to roll a little bit to the left, which means it's about to stall. I'm losing airspeed and there we go. I'm stalling. So I'll drop my throttle and then go ahead and level myself out and then speed out of it. Those are the least dangerous types of stalls, unless you're in a fight, which is probably what you're going to be in when they happen. So they're deadly if you're in a fight, but they won't get you killed if you're just out for a pleasure cruise. Now, if you are out for a pleasure cruise and you do manage to get yourself into a spin, you're in big, big trouble. So I'm going to climb straight up here, and I know this is a contrived example, but you'll find this happening to you through the course of your playing IL-2. So we can see I've stopped forward momentum, and now I'm falling virtually straight down. There we go. Now we are in a spin. So once you get into a spin, it can be really, really difficult to get yourself out. You can fight with the controls. You can do all sorts of stuff. The only reliable way to do it, drop your throttle, push forward on the stick, and dive into it. Now, that gives you a problem in that you're pointing straight down and you have very little speed and you're going to go towards the ground. Put your flaps to combat and slowly roll up out of it. If you see the ground coming up at you fast, put your flaps into takeoff or landing position. That will increase the lift that you get while pulling out of a dive. So if you stall from a lower altitude, like right now, before I was at about 2,000, I'm going to stall out here. You'll see I'll have much less time to recover. I'll probably jam my flaps doing this, but I won't die, hopefully, theoretically. I guess we'll have to find out. Okay, so we started our roll. I'm going to drop my throttle, push forward on the stick. There we go. Put the flaps into landing. It slows us down, and then raise them up. So if you're lower, risk your flaps for it. It all depends on what you're willing to sacrifice to survive. If you're willing to sacrifice your life, then just hope for the best and try to pull up. But the problem is that you risk getting into another stall while pulling out of the stall. You risk rolling your plane back over while diving out, and I'll show you what I mean, while climbing out of the stall. So I'm going to get myself into another stall and a spin here. Alright, throttle down, push it forward, and that's not working. There we go. Sometimes you need to jog the throttle. This is fucked, I'm dead. Alright, I put my flaps to landing, and I'm slowly pulling up, and okay, wow, that actually worked. Okay, and then we'll raise them up. Alright, that was a little closer than I had intended. But the problem is if you are... I'll do this without stalling this time so that I can give you a better example. I'm going to get myself killed here, but I'm going to do it for the sake of science. I'm going to sacrifice my life so that you may learn. So, coming out of a stall is essentially pushing yourself into a dive. Now, I also covered something that I didn't cover before. If you throttle down and push forward and that doesn't get you out of the stall, throttle up, throttle down, throttle up, throttle down, jog it like that as you're spinning, and it'll knock your gyro off to the point where you can come out of it. Alright, so I'm going to put myself into a dive similar to a stall recovery here. I'm going to roll it over, bring it down, throttle down. Alright, so now we're recovering from our stall, blah 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 blah. Now, if you pull up too fast here, you'll get yourself into another stall, like this. So you need to be really, really careful in order to come out of that alive. That's why you don't pull up on your stick too hard, because you can stall off of a stall as well. And this may seem very scary, but if you take a plane out and just do that for practice, once that happens in a combat situation, you'll know what to do. You'll throttle down, push the stick forward, and jog your way out of it in no time. Then you'll be in the unenviable position of being low and slow, which is what will get you killed. So, I think next we'll cover combat tactics, scissor rolls, and dogfighting.